Alright, ladies and gentlemen, guess what? I keep my promise. And I bring you here,
Radiant
Kiev,
team.
major open qualifier for Southeast Asia, the match between Team Mineski Malaysia versus Team Ivy. In best of one match, guys, whoever loses match will be out of tournament. And, yep, you're here with me, Cyclops, as your caster. Oh,
Radiant team ban.
this is actually the first time that I cast Mineski MY new players.
Dire
Oh, I gotta
team
say
ban.
first that their players are Mushi, Extinct, KYXY,
Radiant
Alacrity,
team pick.
and the other guy is Kang. If I'm not wrong, they're saying Mushi is playing position 4.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Finally, we'll get to see how good they are in Mineski Malaysia.
Reserve time.
First pick from Team Ivy, casted by Hard to Forget. First pick, Crystal Maiden.
Dire team pick.
Mineski Malaysia. Let's
Ten
talk about the
seconds
team a
remaining.
bit before we go into that game. Well, I'm gonna
Five
shout out to
seconds remaining.
my analysts for gathering all this information for me. Mineski Malaysia, or Mineski
Radiant
Malaysia, is
team
the
pick.
first time that Mushi, Kang, or KYXY have played on a team not based in Malaysia or China. Extinct spent time with Australian teams Can't Say Wisp and Bananas in 2015. Well, ex-Orange
10
teammates
seconds
Mushi,
remaining.
KYXY, and Xting will be reunited in this Mineski
Five
Malaysia in
seconds
these
remaining.
open qualifiers. The other two members of Orange, a third place
Reserve
TI
time.
squad, could potentially face off against Mineski Malaysia net. Mushi has played 10 competitive games on Spectre and is yet to lose 10 games on Spectre,
Dire team ban.
including 27-4 win against OG at the Shanghai Major. In this game, Mushi Spectre has had like 12.3k hero damage. It seems like he's very good at Spectre for Mushi, but sadly, it seems like
Ten
he's going to
seconds
play
remaining.
position 4 this one for Team Mineski Malaysia.
5 seconds remaining.
Very nice
Radiant
fact.
team ban.
Well, let's take a look at the graph first. A disruptor. I am not a fan of the first two pick supports, to be honest. I feels like if you pick supports in the first two picks, it is so easy to predict
10 seconds
what you're gonna play
remaining.
core, but according to your supports.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Reserve times already for team, but keep in mind, guys, anything happened in best of one games. Anything happened in best of one games. If you just made a small mistake during the game, you failed the execution, you let the opponent slip away only one or two times, that can actually affect the game. And if you lose the game, come back again in open qualifiers number two, mate. It's kind of funny. Do you know that the day?
Dire team ban.
Wait, huh?
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds
Ah,
remaining.
Come on.
Radiant team ban. 10 seconds remaining.
Meeple.
5 seconds remaining.
Oops. I gotta turn
Reserve
off
time.
My Skype a bit. Okay. Do you know that Ehome was knocked out of the tournament because of Meeple? Maybe that's why Mineski Malaysia banned out Meeple. They don't know who their opponent is, but the only heroes that can kill them seems to be a Meeple.
Dire team pick.
Nyx Assassin is gonna be Nyx.
Radiant team pick.
Not sure, is it gonna be KY? So I don't think so. It should be Kang Nyx Assassin. And Viva by KYXY.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
How to deal with this next scene?
Seconds remaining.
Now running out of time already for Team Ivy.
5 seconds remaining.
Faceless Void.
Ooh, Faceless Void.
Dire team pick.
I really like that. Not so many team pick a Faceless Void these days. It's still quite strong in terms of offlaner or a hard carry. Top Tarmin.
Radiant team pick.
Interesting, Chow Chan.
Tinker. 10 seconds remaining. Dire team back.
HLD is extinct, it seems. Extinct is a drafter.
Seconds remaining.
Alacrity will be played as the core heroes.
Radiant team back.
Last ban from Team Ivy. They if you take a look at the heroes, you see that if the game goes late, like super late, they got chance
remaining.
For Team Ivy. But now they're gonna think about how
Five
to deal with the Child Charm and Massive and Wards. They're gonna need some heroes that can
Radiant
walk in and kill the
pick.
Wards. Not sure how they're gonna play the Faceless Void though. Could be a hard carry going for like Power Triad, Lincoln Sphere, or even Echo Saber.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Last pick from Team Ivy. Klinks.
Dire team pick.
Very good draft, let's say. It's very good draft, even though they kind of lack of the tanker for Team Ivy, but Faceless Void open with the Chronosphere, and then Klinks come in and shoot everyone down. It seems to be a good choice.
10 seconds remaining.
Now what they need is just good execution. I'm pretty sure it's going to be a dual lane at top. Faceless Void team will be some Disruptor or Crystal Maiden together. Say hi to all the guys in the chat room. Thank you so much for tuning in. One and a half minute. class hero, the mid heroes of Team Mineski Malaysia, is gonna be Invoker for Alacrity. Or maybe KY is one Invoker. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the games already. I'm gonna do some quick intro before we start. For Team Ivy in a Radiant side, the specialist on Clings is going somewhere. And Ma Byring on Crystal Maiden, the carrying teammate on Disruptor. Hard to forget on Tinker and Lyons on the Faces Void for Team Mineski and MY in the Dire side. Extinct on Chao Charmin. Seems to be Muji, I'm pretty sure, on Ogre Magi. And Alacrity on Invoker. Kang on Blink Dagger. And KYXY on Weaver. Byring.
The battle begins.
The creep blocking is very important for this game. Having a good creep block for Alacrity. New players. He should be a pop star or something. Alacrity versus hard to forget mid lane. Tinker versus Invoker. Bottom lane is gonna be a dual lane. Muji playing Ogre Magi, I believe, with that Kang on Nyxazine versus Tri lane from Team Ivy. The carrying teammates on Disruptor. The specialist. Oh, he was a little bit too offside. Glimpse somebody back. Specialist keeps shooting. My Byring. Crystal Maiden just will be played as position 4 farming in NC. Well, top lane, Lyons. Faces Void, solo off lane. Jumped away for Lyons. Doing pretty okay for Ivy in the first minute of the game. No first blood yet. But that was a little bit too offside. You know, the supporters of Team Ivy need to be careful. They are laying against the most dangerous players in this tournament. Just one small mistake can easily cost their life. This area is very, very important for both parties. Hard to forget. Tinker coming in quite deep. He knows that Ma Byring is farming around here. And now he picked up the body rune. Muji. I think it's going to be Muji for the Ogre Magi trying to force Ma Byring away from his free farming in the NC. Ma Byring, middle lane, might get caught, hard to forget, only 50% HP. Somebody is ready to go from behind. It's going to be HLD Xtain. That is very, very risky and aggressive. Gang coming out from HLD Xtain. Here we go. Alacrity. First blood goes to Alacrity. My Byron teleport down too slow. That was very good gang from Xtain. Wow, you know. He's not that rusty as you guys think. Xtain has been playing with some Australian teams for a while, for maybe like a year. Struggle hard to come back to the scene for Xtain until they join Mucci's team. Demised. Top lane Lions. Xtain keep roaming around. You know, I always thinking that this is not a good ganker for short time because he's very squishy and he's very slow, and now he's coming back in again. Here we go. The standstill. That was great gank coming back in again. I'm pretty sure that hard to forget, didn't even expect that one. Shackles. Very, very dangerous. He already got a boot. Moving around with 330 movement speed is enough to reach Radiant's the target with no boots. He might do it again though. Top lane, now they leave the Diva alone. He knows that KYXY is doing good. Dropping some observer wards. Disruptor now rotate to the middle lane. Now here we go, Mushi diving in. That was so physical coming out of that Mushi. Ignite and they just keep hitting with a torch. 3-0 already. Seems like Mushi's team is doing very, very good in the first 5 minutes of the game. Alacrity. Owning the lane with an invoker. With a good gang of support, it's so easy to own the lane. Alacrity. Dropping quite low for Lyons. It's out, he's against. Cold snap, then Sunstrike. What a gank by Alacrity and Xtain. Just one cold snap mini stun is just enough to kill a guy. Follow up with the shackles. Ether Chalk. Diving in. Playing very aggressive for Team Mucci. Especially just gonna bone walk away. Not looking good at all for Team Ivy. Hard to forget, down 3 times already. But one thing about Tinker, no matter how bad it is for his early game, he still can come back in late game. He just need a boot of travel before the game end. He can come back anytime. Mark Byron was scouted by that Mushi. Firing. Here we go. Fire blast. Everything on my firing. Sunstrike as well. Dropping quite low. One hit. Mushi got him, but he was chased down by the specialist. Still, Team Ivy still cannot find the first kills in this game. Dropping quite low. Mushi get glimpsed back, but no circle setting up. Here we go. The circle, but it was 1v3. That might be another kill for Team Mineski MY, and that's what I'm talking about. Though, especially gotta run away because he was so low. He's gonna get hit by the Vendetta. He's eating some Tango. Not gonna help. Another bone walk away. 0-6. Lions. Made a specialist. Here go the fire blast, everything Sunstrike. Sunstrike played a big part in this game. Killing sprees already for Extinct. Roaming around with a brown boot, you know, shackle people's ether chalk and all these stuff. Doing circles, setting up the circle, and luckily he's stuck in a circle. Here we go, the south. Dropping quite low for Alacrity. Can they get that? Alacrity gets into the tree line. He's gonna be fine. Oh my, hard to forget, gonna run away though, but Mark Byron coming out of nowhere, jumping off the virtual Alacrity. Can they get invoked and two kills for Team Ivy. 2-8 game score. Okay, it's not done yet it seems. That kill from Ivy created some big swing.
Money.
The specialist.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Now they're trying to defense while Minesi MY diving in 3v3 plus tower. Aiming for the support first, carrying teammates. Gonna be the first one who goes down. He carrying his teammate, but nobody cares him at all. The Lion! Oh, the Kralofion too, and the tower shooting on that Uchi too. Viva got one kill on Mark Byron, but they're gonna lose that Ogre Magi. It's not a big deal, the only Ogre Magi only a position 4, hard to forget. Trying to save his spell, not using anything, but oh, a deep impale on 2, hard to forget. Running away, setting up the march, do not find the march. Killing spree with a double kill for Nyxazine. Oh man, look at that technique. Trying to juke for Lyons. Time lapse away. Fancy footwork. This remind me some, you know, some Zinedine Zidane when he was still playing for Juventus. As beautiful as it is for Weaver coming in the perfect timing, you know, Shugi's around. Weaving here and there and finishing the last target and then just time lapse away. That was the first team wipe. I gotta say the Team Ivy tried so hard, we gotta respect them on that. It's supposed to be a very one-sided game if you take a look at the team name first. But no, Ivy is not giving up that easily.
Dire's top tower is under
however,
attack.
Kang is coming in trying to fight his specialist. Kang plays so good. This one got 4 kill, Arcane Boot and a Blink Dagger, and even got a hand of Midas. Mark Byron is the target. Mark Byron, the specialist, and the carrying teammate is in the tower. Are they going to dive? Drop a PO impel, hit the target, and that's a kill. Team communication is very good. You know, what I noticed about this Minesi Malaysia team as I cast them for the first time is that team communication is very, very good. The timing of using the Sunstrike and drop a stun is just perfect. That's gonna be the third tower.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Really? Is Mushi a Charman? I'm not really sure if he a Charman or Ogre Magi, but what I'm sure is he's a support. Might be the Shaman. Let's take a look at the graph a little. Since it's all going back. Wow, farming that stack. Very big, big stack. The graph, of course, will be on Mineski, MY, both golden, experience, earn. And that's the item update. Next scene by Kang trying to find the target is going to be the Faceless Void, but Lyons staying in the tower. Five players of Team Mineski, MY ready to wrap him up like a. Like a nacho. Here we go. The carrying teammates always be the first one who gets found by the enemy team. Double kill, sorry for alacrity. He killed. Kill Crystal Maiden first and then just sunstrike the other guy. Massive and ward. 4 to 17 games worth. So. Such a big difference between two teams. Very well trained, this Mineski Malaysia.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
It's out there for Chow Charmin. Let's pick up the party rune. But I should not waste time. The mid-game transition is very important for Dota 2 these days. It doesn't matter if you win a lot in the early game, if you cannot transition into mid and end the game, you're done. The reason that it is very... Oh, wait. Oh, man! That... Alacrity! Oh my goodness. It's just like he got the CC camera everywhere in the map. Man, that was, we gotta give the credit to the Nexus scene player Kang too. Kang used to be a member of Team WG and now he moves to the other team and enjoy Mineski Malaysia. In my opinion, I think Kang is one of the best performers in WG back then, that they were on top form, finishing a very high place in major tournaments. But I'm not sure what's the story behind that they kicked him out and replaced him with Ben. Well, WG also play in this open qualifiers. The team name is Bazaar. Specialist Kang run after him. That's gonna be another kill for sure. Turning up the dust, and the specialist has been found. Standing still, fire blast, impales comes out. Not gonna make it for sure. The negative urn. Oh, Chrono Fear on two. Let's see, can they finish target or not? It seems like Lion doesn't have enough damage to even kill one Ogama guy. Fireball's already been down, the heat seeking missiles right here, laser triple kill for KYXY, the deny kings. Not to forget. Oh my god, that alacrity. Sun's strike is so on point.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
The anticipation is just awesome. Now here we go, Tornado EMP. It's gonna hit my fiery. Unstoppable is already for the Alacrity. Alacrity should be some top star in Malaysia. That's gonna be the tower goes down and going for the barracks. I got a surprise when Fnatic decided to give up on the Kiev Major, decided to take a break, forming new team But Mucci, who left Fnatic to start the tournament right away with a new team, he really very high passion about the Dota 2 for Mucci. I thought after he left Fnatic he's just gonna turn himself into a coach or something, but he still wanna play it. 5-27, Mineski Malaysia is the victorious. Right after this match, we will try to see if there's any interesting game. And should you guys some edges, stay tuned. More good games coming.
Do you play Dota?